The bromance between you and David Tennant.
I'm sorry, I don't know who you're referring to.
I mean, what is he like to work with? He seems like a joy to work with, and you guys get on really well.
I mean, it's like having an albatross around your neck, really. He sort of does drag you down a lot of the time. No, I feel very lucky. You know, David and I were in a film called Bright Young Things together many, many... Thank you very much. Thank you. But we didn't get to act together in that, and we didn't, you know, we didn't really know each other from that, and we've known each other to say hello to over the years, but it wasn't until we did Good Omens, the first series, really, that we got to know each other, and of course we spent a lot of time together on that, and people would come in and out, but you know, it was essentially me and David sitting in a tent all day, every day, a lot of the time, and so. We sort of slowly got to know each other doing that, and then actually it was probably doing the publicity for that and the press for that we really got to know each other. And then because we both had babies within weeks of each other, you know, me and Anna and David and Georgia, you know, we got very kind of bonded then because of, over that. And we say that, so David and Georgia's little girl Birdie and our little girl Lyra, we say Lyra's only got one friend, and that's Birdie. So we sort of got very close, but we were very lucky because you don't know what the chemistry is going to be like between you and another actor until you start working together. And, you know, interestingly, David and I probably hadn't worked together because a lot of the time we were up for the same parts. Or, you know, there was only one David or Michael-shaped hole in the cast and only one of us would fill it. So we didn't get to work together. And I'd been a big fan of his work. For years and years, and really admired, you know, what he did. And so then getting to work opposite each other, it just sort of clicked very quickly. And I remember when we did the table read for the first series of Good Omens, and we were sitting there next to each other and starting to read the lines together. And we'd not really talked about the characters much before then or how we were going to do it or anything. And you could sort of feel the two of us kind of adapting to each other over the first, you know, few pages. And then we just kind of, it just clicked. The characters just clicked, and we just sort of, without having to talk about it, we just instinctively understood how they would be together. And I remember Neil Gaiman and Douglas, the director, saying that watching it was like that as well. You just saw these characters sort of circling around each other a little bit and sniffing each other out, and then you're just suddenly dancing. And it's been like that ever since, really. It was such a joy to come back and do the second series together again. And it was like, once we put the costumes on again and we were on the Soho set, we filmed it up in Scotland, and they built like an entire block of Soho. On the first one, they only built a small amount of it, and it was in a freezing cold car park outside Oxfordshire, and it was miserable. And this time we were in a lovely warm soundstage with the whole of Soho built. But once we got the costumes on, and I remember our first scene together, because David was a bit ill at the very beginning of the filming, so he wasn't there for the first few days. And then when we did get to do our first scene together, it was just sort of walking across the street or something. And it was almost like the costumes were walking for themselves. Like they just knew what to do. The characters just sort of took over weirdly. And we were in that kind of groove again. So it's an absolute pleasure working with him and spending time with him. And it's so lovely that we found these two characters, or these two characters found us, to be able to sort of put everything into, you know, and to feel so comfortable with each other. It's been brilliant. And I hope when it comes out next summer, I hope everyone really enjoys it. I think there's going to be a lot of great surprises for people, and I hope you enjoy it.